Hey guys, welcome back to the Drone Camps channel. I'm Justin Davis, and today I have something new to show you. This is the Sim 2 folding drone. It's 4K, it has 25 minute flight time, and yada, yada, yada. So I'm gonna give you guys a no BS review on this new Sim 2. Is it a Mavic Pro competitor? Absolutely not. It's in the $400 to $500 range. It doesn't have all the same features as a Mavic, so I'm not even gonna slightly compare it to a Mavic, but I will show you scale-wise how big this one is in relation to a Mavic Pro. And we'll go ahead and get started with what's included with this. And we'll also go outside and take a real world flight test. And I'll show you how the video looks. I'm gonna tell you the good stuff and the bad stuff about this one if you're looking at buying this one. If you don't wanna spend $1,000 on a Mavic Pro, I understand that. And this is pretty cool because it comes with a lot of different stuff. It comes with a watch that you can control. I don't usually use those type of devices because I like to use this traditional remote control, but you do have that option with this one, and for the price it's not that bad. So let's go ahead and get started talking about some of the stuff that comes with it, and the good stuff and the bad stuff coming right up. Okay guys, you're looking at everything that's included with the Dragonfly Sim 2 drone. This is a ready to fly kit. Comes with all the stuff you need: the charger, you get a battery, you get your 4K camera, you get an awesome controller, and you get a nice carrying case with the drone inside, and the gimbal fits inside as well, along with your props. So really awesome that you can also use these same props. You can use DJI Phantom 9450s, the twist on props, the older ones from 2015. They're actually compatible with this quad, so that's actually really cool. And it folds down into a pretty compact little case. And I'm gonna go ahead and try to do this as quickly as possible. These other reviewers make me crazy when they make you sit around for 25 minutes while they slowly unbox everything in there. It makes me totally nuts. So I'm gonna try to get right to the point for you guys. So right away, let's go ahead and look at this 4K camera. And it does have its own battery inside. It has Wi-Fi on board. And this is how it connects to your phone. So is this a good camera for a long distance connection? I would say probably not. I don't know if you're gonna get out there a mile with this one. It does say 1 kilometer on the website, but the video is actually really nice, and I'll show you guys that in a little bit later in the video. It does have some connections on the side here, and it comes with a larger style mini USB cable that can plug in here. You can download these videos to your computer, or you can take out the micro SD card. Now, it did not come with a micro SD card, which was kind of unfortunate, but you can add your own 16 or 32 gigabyte micro SD card, and you can go in there and also put it in photo mode, and you can use this on other drones. So if you have another drone, this it's GoPro compatible, you can put this one on there. Now, you can also put a GoPro on this drone as well. It will fit the older GoPro Black or GoPro Hero 3 Black on this gimbal. So that's a lot of fun. This is swappable, but you're not gonna have that that Wi-Fi connection. You're not gonna have that real-time view if you use a GoPro. And I wouldn't suggest using the GoPro Wi-Fi either to connect to your smartphone, because the Wi-Fi on the GoPro could interfere with the drone itself. Now, the case itself is actually pretty nice. It has a really nice zippers on here that are really extra wide, and they look waterproof. So this case might be quite weather resistant, and it's a really durable exterior, by the way. And I was able to get all of this accessories in here. I was able to get the landing gear inside the back sleeve right here, and the four props. They have a nice spot for the props right here. As you can see, they slide into those slots here. And the drone itself, let's go ahead and take that out and expand that, and I'll show you what this is all about. LEDs on the bottom, a lot like the Mavic. It folds out and locks into place. I don't hear a snapping sound when it locks into place, but it is pretty cool. Let's see, I'll move this to the side so you guys can see a closer view of that. Now, this is gonna be the very front of the quad, because this is where the gimbal slides on and locks into place. This was a little finicky putting the gimbal on. I had to try a few times to get it to seat right. So that's gonna be an interesting process for you. Now, the battery slides and locks into place here, and that's actually pretty easy to do. It has two little locks right here and here. There's a little release button on the back to release the battery. Now, this quad also has GLONASS on board. And what is GLONASS? GLONASS. GLONASS is North American and Russian satellites. So you get an upwards of 16 satellites or more on this quad when you put it on the ground and you load up the home point. So this one also has altitude hold and all that good stuff. Follow me, orbit mode. A lot of the new features that most people expect nowadays on their drones is included in this quad. Now also, a lot like the Phantom, and I keep comparing it back to the Phantom, they are using 2212 motors on here, and they are clockwise and counterclockwise, so they are labeled, and the props actually have color coding on them as well, so you can't, and they're threaded differently, so you can't actually mess up putting the props on, which is really nice for beginners. This quad also has four 20 amp ESCs inside the frame, and the main body of the quad is all industrial plastic, and they did a nice detail up inside here. I'm not sure if the other reviewers covered this, but they do have braided covering over top of the wire, so that when you fold this, a lot like the Mavic has the same braided wire covering on the inside of the frame here so that they don't get pinched when you're folding things, and it folds up quite nice. The arms on this are also carbon fiber, so that's also a very nice detail. It's going to lighten up things a lot, and it's going to strengthen this quad a lot while it's flying. It's going to make it a lot more rigid and a better flying quad. Now these are the landing gear that come along with the Sim 2 Dragonfly, and they're pretty nice because they go on and off really easily. They are removable without the use of tools. You just have to just pull them off. They snap, they go up on the side of the frame and they snap into place. There is a little part right here that you might have to take a pin or something and push down manually here, and then it will slide past that and lock into place just like that. Now on the other side, you can put this one on as well. And you just need to gently push on this locking pin here for it to go past it like this. Okay, so now the landing gear on. That was pretty easy. It only took about 30 seconds to put the landing gear on this quad, pretty quick. Now let's go ahead and take the props out, and we'll remove the gimbal as well, and I'll show you how that goes on. The first time I put it on, it was a little bit hard to get this gimbal on, but I want to tell you about the quality of this gimbal. This is a really nice gimbal. The motors, the brushless motors on the front and the back, they feel very, very nice. The magnets in there feel really solid, and it feels like a really solid gimbal. So it's not a real chintzy gimbal that you get with this little Dragonfly drone. It's actually pretty nice. The camera just slides onto this little mini USB port here from the side. And then it has two locking devices that you put over top of it. And it has a camera guard here. And you can screw these down by hand. And what I usually do, just to make sure that they're nice and tight, is I take a little tiny pair of like needle nose pliers, and I just kind of gently tighten them one more half turn when it's into the threading here. And that just makes sure that it doesn't slip off. You don't want to under tighten these and have these fall off in the air. Now, the cool thing about this camera is that this camera is ready to go once you put on your battery and you power it up. This camera comes on and it starts throwing out a Wi-Fi signal automatically. You're going to go on your phone and go into your settings and connect just like you would if you're connecting to your home Wi-Fi. You go out over to your settings and you find Sim2 in the Wi-Fi listing, and you have to enter in the password 12345678900, I believe, for the password on that. And once you do it one time, you don't have to do it again. Now the gimbal itself has a few connection points here on the bottom. Those have to line up correctly, and I'll bring this in a little closer so you can see it here. It has to line up correctly when you put this on, and this is the rear and this is the front of the gimbal. So you're going to put it on the drone just like this, and it's going to slide back into place. You want to make sure you feel it moving along this rail on the very bottom of the drone. So go ahead and slide it back, and it should firmly lock into place, and you'll hear these two clips on the side snap into place. Now when you put this gimbal on, make sure that the back of it's not sticking up, because there is a little tab right back here that has to slide in and kind of lock into place, and there's two tabs on each side. It's not going to power up and level out correctly if it's on a little bit crooked. it's on just a little bit crooked, your gimbal is going to swing around and do crazy stuff. It does take a minute for this gimbal to load when you first turn it on, so just be aware of that when you're putting this gimbal together. Now, like I was saying earlier, the props are color-coded, so you have a black one here and the silver prop here, and it also has icons on the prop, just like the DJI Phantoms have, and they twist to the right. So this is going to be a counterclockwise prop, and this will be a counterclockwise motor. And now for the black one. The black one is going to spin on counterclockwise, and this motor is going to turn clockwise. So as it turns, it's going to tighten up the prop on here. Make sure that you get them on nice and firm. Don't over tighten these, because you don't want to have any kind of problem getting it off. They are a little bit hard to get off sometimes if you over tighten them. The Dragonfly does come with a smart battery. It has a little push button on the side of it here, and it has LED status readout, 100%, 75%, 50%, and 25%. It's a 3S5200 battery, and you're going to get 20 to 25 minutes flight time out of this battery. Not bad at all. It has a standard XT60 style main port here, and there's a balance plug that sticks out right here for charging from your micro charger right here, and it charges in probably 1 to 2 hours charge time for this battery. And like I said, it is a 3S battery. This also charges 2S batteries on this port if you have a 2S battery you need to charge. So that's actually pretty cool too, that this one does multiple style batteries. So this is the watch that comes along with the drone. It's a smart watch that has a lot of same features that you can use inside your app right here on the watch. So if you wanted to use it without the controller, it gives you that option. And that's pretty nice, because you have a lot of telemetry on this watch. You can tell how many satellites you have, the home position there. If you need to return home, you can do that from this watch as well. It shows you what mode you're in. It'll do follow me. So you can actually have this on your arm and it'll follow you around if you're riding a motorcycle or a snowboard, or you're surfing or something. You can get this waterproof somehow and on your arm. That's actually pretty cool. If you put this in a dry bag, you could surf with it. It also has satellite count up top and bottom there. You have your time code for your video. So you have a few different buttons here. You have takeoff and auto land here. You also have your follow me button up here on the top, and you have positive and negative buttons here, and your power buttons on the bottom here. On the side over here, you have this little wheel, and this will actually turn the gimbal. So you can actually turn the gimbal around up and down, which is really, really nice. Some of the other smartwatches I've seen don't do that. That's really nice. And you also have a charge port over here on the side for USB port to charge it. And make sure you go out, when you go out for the first time, make sure this is fully charged. So I have the quad powered up, and I turn on the transmitter first, and you turn on the quad itself, and the gimbal automatically loads up. Now, if your gimbal swings around to the side, just push it over and then use your adjustment wheel on the very right-hand side of the controller to straighten it out. Now when flying this one, I noticed that I kept hitting this wheel a little bit and getting it just off center. So it is really cool that you can turn the gimbal left and right with this wheel. A lot of these other quads don't have this option on the gimbal. You actually have to turn the drone left or right. So this is really cool that it actually turns on that horizontal axis, which actually is going to let it do the panoramic shot. So you actually have a mode inside the app that will let it do panoramas. So that's also pretty cool. So inside the Wi-Fi in your phone, go ahead and select SIM2 ground, and it'll beep once when you get connected. Go ahead and open up the SIM2 app. This is the Dragonfly SIM2 app. Press connect here on the camera, and it should load into the camera screen and show you that real-time view. And it crashed just then, so you do get a actual real-time live look at how well this app functions. So I don't have an SD card in there now, but the live view is going to go ahead and load up. You can go into horizontal mode there, and I can turn the camera, like I said, left and right. And what's neat about this is I can also do straight down at the ground, or I can go all the way right back up to horizontal. Now this doesn't have a notch where center is, so that kind of annoys me on this little left and right wheel, but What I'll probably do is have to mark it on this transmitter, or mark the wheel actually where center is, so that I get a proper centering. Because once you're up in the air, it's kind of hard to tell which way it's actually facing. But the app is fully featured. It has a lot of different modes in here. We have intelligent flight modes like auto takeoff, auto land, we have auto hover, we have follow me in here, we have auto rotate, it'll rotate around you and follow you at the same time. It also does POI, which is called point of interest, and that is really nice for focusing in on a certain subject. You can have return to home, so if this transmitter turns off completely, it'll go into RTL and it'll actually come back and land in the point where it took off, and that's actually pretty cool too. So a bunch of different modes are included with this quad, and the interface is actually really clean. So it's you can also go in here, and I don't have the SD card in right now, but you can change it from photo mode to video mode and back and forth. You can also change the camera resolution in here. You can set up your flight modes as well over here on the left. And if you're using the watch, you don't really have to use any of this, which is kind of cool. Now, just gonna show you a little close-up of the transmitter. Throttle is on the left, and you can see that's a self-centering throttle stick. So it goes back to center, and what that means is this drone is an altitude hold drone. So if you just bump the throttle up, it's gonna raise up a little bit. The drone's gonna go up, and it's gonna maintain its position and altitude. And if you push it down, it's gonna come down and descend. Then you have left and right, and that's on the yaw axis, so that'll turn the quad left and right. Over here we have roll, left and right, and we have pitch, forward and back. On off button is here. We have return to home. If something really goes bad, we can do that right there. And we have auto land and auto takeoff here. The charge port is on the very bottom, and I have it charging right now as we show you this. You also have an initialize mode on here, and it'll show you what mode you're in. If you're in follow mode, it should say it right there where initialized is. You have your satellite count. We're in the studio right now, so we don't have any satellites, but you also have your Wi-Fi connection strength, and you have your battery level on the transmitter and on the quad itself. Down here you have your time code, you have your mode, and your return to home icon right there. So pretty cool. There's a lot of different features built into this one, and it's actually an economical price. Now let's talk about my final opinion about the Sim 2 Dragonfly. I mean, is this worth the money? I mean, with everything you get here, I think so. I would say that the quality is not as good as something like a DJI Mavic. I'm not going to compare it to that at all, or something in the $1,000 range, by no means. But there's a lot of tech packed into what you get here from the $400 to $500 range. So I gotta say, like, very good value for the money. You get a lot of stuff included with this, a 3-axis gimbal that you can also turn left and right, which I find super cool for panoramas, and that's something different for drones, and that's pretty cool. You also get those interchangeable DJI style props, those 9450 spin-on props, and that's actually really cool. You get that folding function on here, and it breaks down into almost nothing inside this really nice case that comes along with it. The cool optional 2 and 3S charger, the watch if you want to experiment with that or play around with trying to film yourself and do follow me. So it's got a lot of stuff built into this. The Wi-Fi, the app is fully functional, and you have also an LCD display on the controller. The controller feels nice in your hands, and this actually runs for about 12 hours. So that's also a great value. Everything here is included with this kit. So not bad at all, guys, over at Sim 2. So I'd like to see what else Sim 2 has coming up in the next few months, because this is really a neat addition to the aerial drone category. Now, before we go out and fly the Sim 2, I wanted to go ahead and show you a comparison with the DJI Mavic Pro. Just a size comparison, folded and unfolded, so you guys can see the full wingspan of both of these and see how they compare. Obviously, you got much bigger motors on the Sim 2, so you're gonna have quite a bit more power with this quad. These motors are quite a bit smaller. They look to be something in the range of like 1806, I would say. And these are much, much larger, probably twice the size. So quite a bit more power. Now you're going to get around, I believe it was 28 minutes flight time with the Mavic, and you do have that smart battery on that Mavic as well, but you have the same thing on this one. So for the different modes, this one does have quite a bit more modes like tap fly and all that cool stuff like subject tracking. But then again, you're going to spend $1,000 for the Mavic Pro. And the Mavic Pro also has that gimbal that you cannot remove. So it's also very fragile. So if you just bump this one a little bit, you're gonna have to send this one back to DJI. Probably the repair on this is gonna be as much as this one cost. So big cost factor, big difference with the cost factor of the Mavic Pro. Now let's go ahead and open these up. I'll go ahead and swing these arms out and lock it into place. And this brings it out to the size of something like a Phantom, like a DJI Phantom. It's actually a pretty nice scale. And we'll go ahead and fold out the Mavic Pro there. These back arms fold down and under. So scoot this one over so you can see both of them in here. And the Mavic Pro's footprint is actually quite a bit smaller. And like I said, most of the components on this one are quite a bit smaller than the SIM 2 Dragonfly, but they're very similar in size once they break down. They're actually pretty close in size and scale. We'll show you that from the front. The top, let's look at them from the side. This arm moves quite easily on the Mavic. And they're about the same thickness, which is actually kind of surprising. The Mavic almost looks like it's a little bit taller. Very, very close in size. But like I said, you're gonna get a much larger wingspan with this SIM 2 Dragonfly. So this one might even be a little bit quieter. This one sounds a little more like a Phantom, like a DJI Phantom. So without further ado, guys, let's go out into the field and see what this camera quality looks like and how well this gimbal works. And we'll see if it's worth the money.